Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Wa alaikum salam
wa rahmatullah. Hi, Brother Zillu.
Good, alhamdulillah. How are you, Imam?
Alhamdulillah. Brother Zillu Rahman is our secretary, a member of our trustee board. Alhamdulillah, Zillu, what is the vision of Lewisham Islamic Centre, especially with the new development?
Yeah, I mean, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I think we've got an amazing opportunity to finally realise this dream of having our own purpose-built masjid here in Lewisham. It's probably the only London borough that doesn't have one. In terms of the range of facilities and services that we can offer, of course, it's going to broaden a lot more than what we can do at the moment. And even now, I think we're doing more than we can in terms of capacity, alhamdulillah. But we would be able to provide facilities in terms of education, culture, arts, recreation, sports. There will be, of course, a greater prayer space for worshippers. There will be a cafeteria, inshallah, that will allow for greater social interaction in the community. There will be an exhibition area, which I think would be fantastic for this, for our masjid, in terms of inviting people and teaching them about Islam. Because as we know, one of the great features of this masjid is that the number of Muslims, new Muslims that we have, and I think you know better than I, Imam, that we probably have 3 to 5 new shahadas every week. Mm-hmm. In fact, I remember one February some years ago. There's 28 days in February, but that particular month, I think we had more than 28 shahadas that month. Alhamdulillah. There will also be provision for sports as well. We hope that there can be a multi-purpose court, indoor court, that would allow for various different games such as netball, indoor football, badminton, tennis, basketball, that can be used by members of the community. And all these facilities are both for men, women, and for Muslims and the non-Muslim community as well. We also hope that the masjid, certain parts, certain sections of the mosque will be named with different parts from the Muslim world. And I think this is important because it really represents what the Muslim community of Lewisham is, in that whilst the exterior of the mosque is contemporary in its design and it fits its surrounding, so too you'll find that the Muslim community of Lewisham, that they are confident in their British identity, but yet they still recognise and have that solidarity and oneness with the global Muslim community as well. So, you know, inshallah, I think, you know, it is a dream that we've been having for a number of years, and hopefully we can finally realise this dream, inshallah.
Inshallah, jazakallah for that, inshallah. In terms of the support, what kind of support do you need from the community and from, you know, our viewers in terms of fulfilling this dream that we have?
I think the main contribution that we need is that we need their du'as, we need their prayers. It's a mammoth task that's ahead of us. You know, we're not underestimating that. So we need their support in that respect. Of course, there's going to be, it's not all going to be plain sailing. There's going to be some rocky roads as we go along. So we need to stick together. I think the main thing is that we stick together once we've embarked on this project. And of course, we need their commitment to this. The community has never let us down. And in fact, it's been one of our greatest strengths and assets, is that the community has always been one. The Jama'at has always been one. In fact, that's probably why we don't have loads of masajids in Lewisham. We've only got this one here, and there's a small one further down the road, which is more just a prayer area. And alhamdulillah, that's to our credit. And the reason why we don't have this is because people don't feel a need to splinter and create their own masjids, because they feel a sense of belonging to this mosque. So, you know, alhamdulillah, I think we keep that together and that oneness. And of course, we need that financial contribution as well. So I think everyone's got to think about ways of developing that in terms of strategizing with family members, friends, thinking of things that they can do that can help raise those funds, inshallah.
Jazakallah khair. I think very important points that Zillu has mentioned. It is a community masjid. And in that, you know, it's following in the tradition of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that was a community masjid, not owned by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but it was a part of society that the Sahaba were taking part in, the Sahabiyat were taking part in, and of course the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's always been our vision, the vision, i.e. making our masjid as close as possible to the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And some of the services that Brother Zillu mentioned, sports activities, recreational activities, arts, crafts, and so on and so on. This is our vision, because the Masjid of the Prophet ﷺ welcomed everyone from Muslim to non-Muslim, to shahadas, to teaching, to educating, to training, to looking after kids and so on. In the same way, we want our masjid, especially with the new development, to be that way. And as Zillu mentioned, dua, of course, because everything is in the hands of Allah Ta'ala. We need to turn to Allah Ta'ala and ask Allah Ta'ala to make this happen for us and give us a tawfiq and the lifespan to be able to achieve this, inshallah. But also, secondly, brothers and sisters, please, inshallah, contribute. The Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hadith, he said, "Ma naqasa malun min sadaqah." Wealth does not decrease by giving sadaqah. What does it mean? Sadaqah only increases our wealth. Allah Ta'ala will put barakah in your wealth when you, inshallah, contribute to this great legacy. The legacy, inshallah, what we're trying to achieve here of a purpose-built masjid on this site, at Lewisham Islamic Center site. And inshallah, this will be a legacy that will remain for many, many, many years to come. And Muslims will benefit, but inshallah, as I've mentioned before, that inshallah, it will be a center of guidance and inshallah, goodness and khair and positivity for Muslims also. So thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, and thank you to Brother Zillu as well.